愿主与你们同在，
与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣若望福音。那时候，耶稣的门徒中有许多人听了他讲的话，便说：“这话太难了，谁能听得进去呢？”耶稣自知他的门徒为了这些话议论纷纷，便对他们说：“这话使你们起反感吗？如果你们将来看见人子升到他原来所在的地方去，又将怎样呢？使人生活的是圣神，肉体一无所有。我对你们所说的话是圣神所给的，也是生命。但是你们当中有些人却不相信。”原来耶稣从起初就知道哪些人不信，谁又要出卖他，所以他接着说：“因此我对你们说过，除非蒙父恩赐的，谁也不能到我这里来。”从此他的门徒中有许多人离开了他，不再同他往来。于是耶稣对那十二门徒说：“难道你们也愿意退出吗？”西满伯多禄回答说：“主啊，唯独你有永生的话，我们还投奔谁呢？我们相信，而且已经知道你是从天主那里来的生者。”基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
在过去的几个星期里，我们已经听了耶稣说关于自己是来自于天堂的生命之粮。他教导我们，他被天父派遣来到这个世上，以带给全人类永生。他也教导我们，我们必须吃他的肉，喝他的血。而这个教导让他许多的门徒无法接受，他们无法理解耶稣说他们必须吃他的肉和喝他的血到底是什么意思。为什么他们需要这么做？他们又如何做到呢？所以实际上这是一件特别难以理解的教导，以至于很多人离开了耶稣，并且不再跟随他。但事实上，这也是可以理解的，因为他们需要在耶稣的最后晚餐，以及他死而复活过后，这个教导才清晰可见。也只有这样才能理解他所说的，他是来自于天堂的生命之粮，并且相信他，以及吃他的肉，以喝他的血，他将在末日时使他们复活。在还没有见证耶稣的苦难、死亡以及复活，我们是无法明白吃他的肉与喝他的血的这个教导。在最后晚餐时，耶稣显示给我们如何吃他的肉与喝他的血。他做了第一台弥撒，也就是他自己的牺牲和为了世上的救赎的自我奉献。面饼 与酒转化成为他的身体与血，作为奉献的祭品。当他的身体与血作为祭献的祭品，以赦免我们的罪时，这预示了他将死在十字架上。就这样，他以自己的性命赎回了我们的生命。他作为天主的圣者，成为了世界的救主，以及借着他的身体与血，我们的罪过得以洁净，并且得到永恒的生命，末日时也将复活。这同样的救赎奥迹，也是我们在每次的弥撒当中所领受的。弥撒不但只是一个祈祷的时刻，或者赞美和朝拜的时刻，远远不止如此。我们再次来到加尔瓦略山那里，见证了那个时刻，也就是耶稣交出自己的性命，为了全世界的救赎。透过领受在身体中耶稣，我们完成了这个伟大奥迹的参与。当我们领受了耶稣，我们成为了他肢体的一员，我们成为了他的身体与血的一份子，与他合而为一，我们就能与天主合而为一，而与天主合而为一，我们便分享了永恒的生命。因此，这确实是一次最神圣的共荣。在此期间，我们与天主合一，预先体验到天堂。我们在圣祭当中所领受的面饼，虽然外表看起来像普通的面饼，但实际上不再是面饼，而是基督的至圣身体。它不再只是一片神圣的面饼，而是至圣的身体。这也是作为天主教徒的我们所相信的。那如果它只是一片面饼，那它有什么特别之处呢？如果它仅仅是一个象征，而非真实的，那领受它有什么意义呢？因此，当神父对你说基督的身体，而你回答阿们，是如此的重要，因为这阿们表示是我相信，这正是基督的身体从天堂而来的生命之粮。借着这个阿们，我们表示我们在救主耶稣内的信德，以及我们展示成为他肢体一员的渴望，与他合一。也借着这个阿们，我们就像西门伯多禄在今天的福音里所说的：“主啊，唯独你有永生的话，我们还投奔谁呢？”我们相信，而且已经知道你是从天主那里来的圣者。So my dear brothers and sisters, for the past few weeks, we have been listening to Jesus speaking about himself as the bread of life that has come down from heaven. He teaches us that the Father has sent him to the world to bring eternal life to humanity. He also tells us that we must eat his body and drink his blood. Now, this is a teaching that many of Jesus' disciples found very hard to accept. And so, they chose to not follow him anymore. But you know, it's really understandable that they were not able to understand this teaching. It is indeed strange to eat someone's flesh and drink their blood. Now, it's only possible to understand what Jesus meant by saying this if we first witness the Last Supper. At the Last Supper, we know he offered the bread and the wine. And that is how we can receive his body and blood. And not only that, we must witness him at the foot of Calvary on the day he is crucified, when he dies for our sins, and then he is resurrected to life. Only then we can understand that eating his body, drinking his blood, means eternal life for us. By eating his body, drinking his blood, in Holy Communion, we become part of the Paschal mystery, that is, the mystery of the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of Jesus. So, my dear brothers and sisters, after so many weeks of hearing the reading from St. John's Gospel, chapter 6, about Jesus, the bread of life, today we can fully understand. We must first be present at the Last Supper, and then know that at the Last Supper, at every Mass, we are participating in the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of Christ. And it is in his Passion, Death, and Resurrection that we have received the forgiveness of our sins and the gift of eternal life. Now, finally, the last point I shared was the importance of saying Amen. When you come to receive Holy Communion, the priest will say, the body of Christ. And you must reply, Amen. So if you don't apply Amen, we will say Amen for you. Because it's so important to say Amen. And what does that Amen mean? It means, yes, I believe. This is really body of Christ. It's not just bread. This is really body of Jesus, the one who died on the cross for me. And now he is going to enter into my body so that I can become part of his body. And when I am part of his body, I have eternal life. So that's how important the Amen is, right? So remember, when you receive Holy Communion, please say Amen. Body of Christ, Amen. And that's what it means. Yes, I believe. All right, so today as we celebrate this Mass, let us give thanks to God for the great gift of Jesus himself. Through Jesus, we become one with God, and we receive a foretaste of heaven. Truly, he is the bread of life from heaven given to us.